Hello everyone, welcome to Verma's Knowledge Hub. Today we are going to continue our previous session, that is a video on phrasal verbs, part 2. In the last class we discussed what are phrasal verbs, what are different phrasal verbs, and also we studied number of phrasal verbs in the last class. Now I would like to extend the same with part 2. Just as a part of recapitulation, I am going to read the definition once again for you. So the definition is: addition of preposition beside a verb gives different meanings. They are called phrasal verbs. In other way, a phrasal verb is a verb that is made up of main verb together with an adverb or a preposition or both. Typically, their meaning is not obvious from the meanings of the individual words themselves. We have seen the example also in the last class, so I am not going to repeat the same thing now. Let us see the phrasal verbs related to the main verb look. Are you all ready with me? Okay, let us proceed with now. So before moving into the lesson, I would like everyone to like, share and subscribe. So don't forget to subscribe the channel, because if I upload any videos further, you will be able to see the updates in YouTube. Today I request everyone to watch the video till end, because there is a surprise for you. Let us go into our lesson, that is the phrasal verbs related to the main verb look. The first one is look after. Look after means take care of. Example sentence is: I will look after her child when she is on a business trip. That means I will take care of the child when she is on a business trip. Look over means examine or inspect quickly. This is not thorough looking. Look over means just looking peripherally. Example sentence is: we will look over these files for you. That means I will examine these files for you. Next one is look forward means anticipate or expect or hope. He is looking forward to his retirement. That means he is anticipating or expecting his retirement. Look down means threat directly or unimportant. I didn't pass the test, so they looked down on me. That means they treated him unimportant because he failed the test. Look up means show in improvement or search for information. My grades in biology are looking up. That means my grades in biology are improving. Look into means examine or investigate or explore. The police looked into the murder. That means they are examining or they are investigating the murder. Now let us see the phrasal verbs related to the main verb take. Take after means reassemble or similarly. She takes after her grandmother with her wide eyes. That means she is similar to her grandmother in possessing wide eyes. Take down means write. I can take down the notes during his lecture. Take in means understand. It was difficult to take in all she said. That means it is difficult to understand what she said. Take for means regard or to consider. Don't take silence for anger. That means don't mean that my silence is anger. That means take for means regard or consider. So do not consider my silence as anger. Take to means show interest or develop a habit. My son has taken to playing games in the evening. That means my son has developed an interest or a habit in playing in the evening. Next one is take up. Take up means occupy time or space or resume a work. The meeting took up the entire morning. That means the meeting occupied the time for the entire morning. That means it ran throughout the morning. Take off. This we know, that the planes take off to rise into the air. The plane took off on time. So we know what is in time and on time. The plane took off on time. That means the plane rose into the air on time. Let us see some of the phrasal verbs associated with the main verb put. The first one is put on. Put on means wear. He put on his best suit for the wedding. That means he wore the best suit for the wedding. Put away means throw or negligence or keep away. Put away your worries to attain peace. That means if you want to gain peace, keep your worries away. Put aside means out of use or stop using. The children were told to put aside their toys. That means the children were told to stop using the toys. Put by means save money. We will start to put by extra money for next month groceries. That means we will save extra money for our next month groceries. Put through. Put through. Connect by telephone. Example, can you put me through the accounts department? That means we are requesting the person on telephone to connect us to the concerned accounts department. Put up means raise, construct or provide temporary accommodation. Example, the banks put up their interest rates last week. Put off means postpone or escape. Never put off until tomorrow what you can do today. That means never postpone something for tomorrow, because if you can do it today itself. This is all for today, but I have chosen some of the miscellaneous phrasal verbs that we come across now and then with different main verbs. So for our convenience, I have chosen some of them. Let us go through each and every one in detail now. Carry on means continue. This is a common phrasal verb we use in our regular talk. Let's carry on the discussion. That means let's continue the discussion. Bring up means raise the children. She brought up 5 children. Give up means leave a habit or cease. Cease means stop. He gave up smoking last year. That means he stopped smoking last year. Hand in means submit. You must hand in your projects by the end of next week. Breakdown. Breakdown means stop functioning a vehicle or machine, or another meaning for this is get upset. Deep upset is called breakdown. The bus we traveled broke down at the side of the highway. That means the bus stopped functioning or there is a mechanical failure in the bus at the side of the highway. Another example also provided here. The woman broke down when she heard about her son's death. That means she sobbed or cried a lot by seeing her son's death. Break up. End a relationship. This is the common phrasal verb we come across while watching movies. My girlfriend and I broke up before I moved to Hyderabad. So before moving to Hyderabad, they ended their relationship. Hang on means wait for a short term. It is used informally. And hold the telephone line open. Please hang on while I get your details. That means we are talking to the customer care and he is checking our details and asking us to wait for a short time. Okay. He is also requesting us to hold the phone line open. Eat out. Eat at a restaurant. People are spending more on eating out. That means people are spending money on eating in restaurants. This is a big surprise for you here. That is, there is a quiz link given in the description and also the link is given below. By clicking the link given in the description, you will be directed to the quiz section. And in that quiz, I have given 10 questions. I request those who watch this video can go through the quiz and check your proficiency in phrasal verbs. This is for today, friends. Thank you, everyone. I hope you enjoyed watching it. If you like this video, please recommend your friends to like, share and subscribe. If you have not subscribed yet, please do subscribe now because you can watch updates even in future. This is all for today. Thank you everyone. Thank you. Bye bye.